Hey there, Benjamin from Loves Data here, welcome back. In this video, I'm going to show you how to send purchase, add to cart, and other e-commerce events to Google Analytics 4, GA4, from your WooCommerce store. I'm going to show you how to use Google Tag Manager and a WordPress plugin to send these e-commerce events to Google Analytics. This is the easiest way to get up and running, and it will provide a whole range of insights in your GA4 reports. Before we cover the steps to collect e-commerce events from your WooCommerce store, I want you to check if you've already added Google Analytics to your WordPress site. If it's already added, then you might need to make a couple of adjustments. And if you haven't added Google Analytics yet, then you can simply follow the steps we're about to cover. If you have added Google Analytics, then you'll need to ask a few questions. First, how has Google Analytics been installed? Are you using Google's SiteKit plugin, another plugin, or have you added the Google Analytics tag to your template? The second thing to check is if you've added Google Analytics using Google Tag Manager or using Google's Global Site Tag. In this tutorial, we're going to use the GTM for WordPress plugin, so we're going to use Google Tag Manager to send transaction details to Google Analytics. If you're using Google's SiteKit plugin, then you can keep using this if you like. The solution I'm going to show you is compatible with SiteKit. And if you're using the Global Site Tag, I recommend migrating to Google Tag Manager. If this applies to you, then don't worry, I'm going to cover these steps too. Okay, let's head to WordPress. I already have WooCommerce installed on my demo WordPress site, so let's select Plugins. And then Add New. Now let's search for Google Tag Manager. Let's install the GTM for WordPress plugin. And let's activate the plugin. Now let's click Settings. We need to start by entering our container ID from Google Tag Manager. So let's head to Google Tag Manager to find this. We're looking at a new Google Tag Manager container that I've just created, so there's no tags in the container yet. I'm going to cover the steps to add Google Analytics to Google Tag Manager. You'll need to follow these steps if you're getting started with Google Tag Manager for the first time. If you already have your GA4 tag configured, then you can skip ahead using the links in the description below this video. To add our Google Analytics tag, let's select Add a New Tag. Let's name the tag Google Analytics GA4. And let's select Tag Configuration. Now let's choose GA4 Configuration as the tag type. And we need to enter our measurement ID. Let's head to Google Analytics to find this. We need to navigate to Admin. Then select Data Streams. Open the data stream for our WordPress site. And you can copy the measurement ID. Now let's head back to Google Tag Manager. And let's paste the measurement ID into the tag configuration. Now let's select Triggering. And select the All Pages trigger. This will mean that Google Analytics is added to all of the pages where we've added Google Tag Manager. You can preview the changes, but I'm happy with the tag I've added, so I'm going to click Submit. And then Publish. This means we've now published the GA4 tag in our container. The next step is to add Google Tag Manager to our WordPress site, so we need to copy the container ID. We can find this at the top. It starts with GTM and then a dash. Let's copy this. Now let's head back to WordPress. And let's paste our container ID. Make sure there isn't a space at the start or end of the container ID, as this will cause problems. Now, if you want to continue using another plugin to add Google Tag Manager to your WordPress site, you'll need to change the container code option to off. For example, if you're using Google's SiteKit plugin to add Google Tag Manager and you want to continue using that plugin, then just make sure you change this to off. Since I'm adding Google Tag Manager to WordPress for the first time, I'm going to leave this set to on. And now let's click Save Changes. Now let's select the Integration tab and choose WooCommerce. Let's enable the Track Enhanced e-commerce option and click Save Changes. So far, we've added the plugin to our WordPress site and we've added our Google Tag Manager container ID. This means Google Tag Manager can now capture details about our WooCommerce transactions. The next step is to configure Google Tag Manager to pass information about those transactions to Google Analytics. So let's head to Google Tag Manager to report on the way people engage with our store and purchase in Google Analytics. We'll need to set up a tag, trigger, and variables in our container. If you're new to Google Tag Manager and want to learn more about how you can manage your tags, then take a moment to check out my other tutorials and resources. I've included links in the description below this video. Basically, the plugin we installed in WordPress adds a data layer that contains details about the products people view, the actions they take, and when they make a purchase. We can then use variables to capture this information and pass it to our Google Analytics tag. Since we need to add a few different things to Google Tag Manager, I want to save you some time. So I've included a link in the description below this video that lets you download a pre-configured container. Let's import these elements into Google Tag Manager. To do this, let's select Admin at the top. Then Import Container. And let's choose the pre-configured container. I'm going to choose Existing to use my current workspace. And then I'm going to choose Default. And I'm going to select Merge to keep the other tags, variables, and triggers that are already in Google Tag Manager. Now I'm going to click Confirm. We've now imported a new tag, trigger, and variables to send e-commerce details to Google Analytics. Let's select Tags. We can see a new tag has been added. This will send all of the different e-commerce events to GA4. Now let's select Triggers. We can see there is a new trigger. This will look for any e-commerce events so that our GA4 tag will fire. This will include purchases along with item views, add to carts, and more. And let's select Variables. We can see there are a number of user-defined variables that will get the values from the data layer. The values of each of these variables will be sent to Google Analytics. Okay, so now we need to configure the tag. So let's head back to Tags. We can see I already have a GA4 configuration tag. This will automatically send page views to GA4. If you don't have a GA4 configuration tag, then you will need to create one. Now we need to configure the tag we imported to use the GA4 configuration tag. So let's select the GA4 e-commerce tag and select Tag Configuration. Then we need to select our existing GA4 configuration tag and then save the tag. Okay, now we're ready to test things out. So let's click Preview. We enter the URL of our WooCommerce store and click Connect. We can view a product and add the product to our cart. Now, before we make a purchase, let's see what's already been sent to Google Analytics. let's select the Tag Assistant tab. And we can see that our GA4 e-commerce tag has fired a number of times. Let's select the GA4 measurement ID at the top. We can now see all of the different events that have been sent to Google Analytics. And we can see this includes view item and add to cart events. Now let's head back to the site and check out. We enter our details and complete the purchase. We can now see the confirmation page, so let's select the Tag Assistant tab again. We can see additional events have been sent to Google Analytics, and there is a purchase event too. Let's check that the purchase event has come through to GA4, so let's head to Google Analytics. And let's navigate to Configure. And then Debug View. We can see all the e-commerce events, including the purchase event, have come through. And we can select this to see additional details. We've now added Google Tag Manager to our WooCommerce store, and we're sending e-commerce events to Google Analytics 4. If you're using Google's global site tag, gtag.js, to add Google Analytics to WordPress, then now is the time to remove this tag. Just make sure that you've added Google Tag Manager to your site using the plugin we've covered, and that you've added your Google Analytics tag inside Google Tag Manager. Once you've tested your tags and you're happy everything is working correctly, you'll need to publish your changes in Google Tag Manager. Let's head to Google Tag Manager to do this. We just need to click Submit, name our version, and click Publish. Our e-commerce tag, triggers, and variables have now been published to our live WooCommerce store. You'll now be able to use the monetization reports and build your own exploration reports in Google Analytics. Have you added Google Tag Manager and GA4 to WooCommerce? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And if you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing to see more videos about getting the most out of Google Analytics, Google Tag Manager, and more. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.